Hey everyone, we all want to know exactly what frame rates our games are running at. After all, we've all worked hard to build or buy awesome computers that can totally eclipse anything the consoles can deliver. So why wouldn't we want to track our FPS rates and then shout this from the rooftops? Many people nowadays use MSI Afterburner to display their FPS counter, which I'll show in a second. But there's actually 9 other really great ways that you can show your frame rates in games, so I'll cover these too. I'll quickly start with MSI Afterburner since pretty much every tutorial online actually recommends this. You don't need to have an MSI graphics card to use the software, and it's actually pretty powerful. You can download it for free from MSI.com, and during the installation process, make sure that you include RivaTurner, otherwise you won't get any FPS stats. It's the thing that actually powers it. Once it's finished, open it up and head on over to the settings menu. This isn't always the most straightforward area to configure, but if you want hardware monitoring and graph generation, then scroll down in the monitoring section and tick all of the framerate options. Under Show in Screen Display, if you want to see your GPU temps as a graph, then select Text and Graph. Then head on over to the on-screen display area and set the hotkey for the relevant options. You can set a single hotkey here for both show and hide in the FPS counter, or you can specify separate hotkeys for them. It's completely up to you. Finally, if you want the full framerate data, including 1% and 0.1% lows, then head on over to the benchmarking section and select hotkeys to start and stop recording. It's really useful to get all this extra framerate data because having just a single FPS counter somewhere on your screen doesn't always tell you the full story. For example, there might actually be sections of the game where your framerate drops down loads to 20 FPS, for example. You'll need to know this, so you can then look to optimize the settings and have a smoother gaming experience. So there's actually lots of positive with MSI Afterburner, but unfortunately some people have reported that the FPS counter doesn't always show up in some games. This is because MSI Afterburner actually uses RivaTurner, which I mentioned previously, under the hood, and this software is powerful, but it can be a bit buggy in how it actually detects whether a game is running or not. Equally, some games like Battlefield 2042 have issues with the EA anti-cheat software, or DRM, which actually conflicts with the FPS overlay and then basically blocks it. In that case, what's the alternative? Well, if you game through Steam, which, let's be honest, most of us do, then you might be familiar with Steam's own FPS counter. You can enable it by clicking Steam in the top left, and then clicking on Settings. A new menu will then pop up, and in here, navigate to the In-Game tab. You will see two settings here for the actual in-game FPS counter. You can firstly choose where on the screen the FPS counter should be displayed. I tend to like choosing bottom right here just so that it's out of the way of the game and it doesn't get in the way, but you can actually tweak this to your liking. There's then another option to display the FPS counter in a high contrast color. I usually actually like keeping this option enabled because when it's off, you can barely see the FPS counter. It's the little light gray font, and so it doesn't really stand out when you're gaming. As a result, I often game with the high contrast toggle enabled because it then has a solid black background color and a clear green font, meaning you can still see it fairly easily. Unless, of course, you game in higher than 1080p resolution, in which case the counter will be really, really small. Users have actually been asking Steam to be able to change the font size for ages, but Valve have never delivered on this, unfortunately. So you can then either move on to one of the other methods, or you can try hacking one of Steam's config files. I'll put further details for this method down in the description. But to do this, you can actually open up Windows File Explorer, click on your C drive or wherever Steam is installed, then go to Program Files x86, Steam, Resource, and then Layout. Scroll down to the in-game FPS banner.layout file. Before editing this file, though, I should quickly point out that you really should copy and paste this file to make a backup of it, just in case you corrupt it and then Steam keeps crashing on you or something. But once this is done, you'll probably find that you can actually increase the font size values inside this file here to 24 or so, and the FPS counter will then appear bigger in games. Great! However, some people still find this too small, especially when doing 4K gaming. So they've tried pushing the font size up to 36 or so. Unfortunately, this often results in an FPS counter then getting cut off when running Steam. Weirdly though, I actually kind of like this because I'm actually not too concerned about seeing the letters FPS here. I just want the number. So that covers Steam, but what happens if you game with Epic Games, GoG Galaxy, or God forbid, Ubisoft Connect? Well, Epic Games doesn't actually have any inbuilt FPS counter, which is a pity because it's actually a decent enough platform otherwise, especially due to all the free games they give us. Having said that, if you play Rocket League through Epic Games, you can hit F10 and then you get an overlay with some pretty useful stats on it, including your minimum and average frame rates, which is really useful. The only downside to this though is it isn't actually part of Epic Games, it's not a feature that they deliver, it's actually built into Rocket League engine instead. If you game through GoG Galaxy, the situation is a bit more confusing, unfortunately. GoG is meant to have overlay support by clicking Shift and Tab when you're in a game. This overlay is meant to show the game's FPS counter, amongst other things. Unfortunately, I've never actually been able to get this overlay to show up in the handful of games that I have in my GOG library, although granted they are quite old games, some dating back 2 decades or more. Apparently there is a hack you can try which will always force the overlay option, and you can do this by opening File Explorer and type in C program data in the address bar. Then click GOG Galaxy and then Galaxy. Find the file named config.json, back it up, and then add a line in there saying force enable overlay to be true. I should caution though that you need to actually know JSON before editing this file. You can't just blindly add that line in, because the previous line should have a comma added if you add this entry at the last line. Basically, you need to make sure that whatever edit you make still leads to a valid JSON file, otherwise it could crash the game. Once this is done, in theory, you can reboot the game and the GOG launcher and the overlay will always be there. But as I say, this has never worked for me and it doesn't seem to work for all these. Maybe GOG will improve overlay support soon though, I just don't know. Luckily though, Ubisoft have saved the day. Their overlay does appear and it supports an FPS counter. Woohoo! I love Ubisoft. Kidding. To activate this overlay, boot up a game and then hit Shift and F2. This will open up the Ubisoft overlay. Find the FPS option under stats and enable this. An FPS counter will then appear in game and it works fairly well. I mean, it is just an FPS counter, nothing else is displayed. There also aren't any configuration options like being able to move it to make the font size bigger or smaller, which is a bit of a pity. Moving on, let's say that you don't want to rely on your game's FPS counter. Well, a popular option from the past was always FRAPS. In fact, this was the de facto standard until they completely stopped updating the software. This is a big concern, of course, and FRAPS doesn't work with recent games, as I'll cover in a second. But if you mainly play older games, you can still safely download and install FRAPS from fraps.com. I actually just installed it fine on Windows 11 and it works fine for me. The interface does look a bit blurry and buggy at 4K resolution, I'll admit, but you can still easily enough configure where you want the FPS counter to appear on your screen. You then launch up your game and bam! The old school FRAPS FPS counter with its distinctive yellow text and black background appears, which is awesome for nostalgia's sake. This works just fine for older games, it accurately tracks the FPS and it updates the counter really frequently. Of course, it doesn't include things like min, max, and 1% low FPS count that all the modern FPS trackers do, which is something I'll touch on a bit later on. What I do have to point out though is that because FRAPS hasn't been updated in 11 years, it doesn't support modern game engines like Vulkan and DirectX 12, so there's actually loads of recent games that it just won't work reliably with. Now let's look at some more modern solutions. Windows 10 and 11 have the Xbox Game Bar, and this is actually a pretty awesome way of actually seeing your FPS count and more when gaming. To get started, click on the Windows key and G, and this will open the Xbox overlay on your screen. If you don't see any FPS counter section here though, don't worry, just click on the Performance tab a few times and the window should appear in the bottom left. It shows CPU, GPU, VRAM and RAM usage, which is pretty nice. It also has an FPS counter, but you need to actually be in a game to see this. You can configure the settings a fair amount too, turning off the stats that you don't need, along with tweaking the color of the text, how transparent the actual background box should be, and also the layout of the widget itself. For example, you can change where the graph should appear. Once you're done setting this up, you should pin it to your screen and then launch your game, and the FPS counter will then kick into life, which is nice to see. There are a couple of downsides to the Xbox Game Bar though. Firstly, it doesn't always appear in streaming or screen capture programs like OBS, which is why I'm actually recording this section on my phone, as you can see. Equally, the widget can actually block your clicks in-game, which sucks. One time a game actually had a continue button underneath the FPS counter widget, so I actually needed to hit the Windows key and G to move the counter before I could then click on continue in-game, which was a bit rubbish. This approach also doesn't support 1% lows for your FPS tracking or anything like that, which is a pity. The next option open to you is to use the overlay that's actually built into your graphics card software, so AMD software or NVIDIA GeForce Experience. I'll start off with AMD software, and to activate this you need to launch the software, then click on the Performance tab at the top, and then press Overlay on the side. Toggle the Enable Metrics Overlay option, and then you get a nice overlay appear on the screen, which includes the 99th percentile FPS rate, which is actually pretty nice. This is basically the 1% low that your games are having, so the times when your game's graphics are taxing your CPU or GPU or your RAM or whatever a bit too much, and then you get FPS rate drops, so it's nice to be able to see this. You can also configure the size of the overlay, you can also change how many columns it should run over, and also the transparency. It also allows you to change all of the colors too. So in short, this is actually much more powerful than relying on something like Steam's own FPS counter. For some reason though, it wasn't displaying my CPU temps, as you can see, but I can see this in all the other programs like HWInfo, so I don't mind too much. I also like seeing how much power my graphics card is actually using, especially because many of us worry whether our PSU is actually supplying enough power to our graphics card. Being able to know the exact power usage of your GPU helps a lot with this. GeForce Experience for NVIDIA graphics cards also has similar FPS tracking support. I don't have an NVIDIA card, but I'm showing a useful video now on screen that covers how to enable the in-game overlay and then configure it so that an FPS counter will appear in your games. And you can then see that you're able to move the position of the FPS counter around. Then when you actually launch a game, you have a simple FPS counter that appears. You can also hit Alt and Z to bring up the GeForce overlay and tweak the settings further if you would like. I'm assuming that you can actually display more than just the FPS counter based on all the videos that I've watched of this feature. But obviously I haven't been able to try it out myself, so please let us know down in the comments exactly what stats you can enable through GeForce Experience. Next up, we have a paid for solution, and I personally love this one, but I'm not affiliated with them or anything. I actually pay $10 for a license out of my own money.
Because it's a tax write-off.
So this is FPS Monitor, and it has a crazy amount of configuration options, probably more than any of the other FPS counters that I've actually covered so far. You can show loads of detail, or you can just keep it all minimal. It's completely up to you. You can also try this software out with a free demo, but if you plan on using this software much, then you'll need to buy a license, which basically costs $10. You can configure pretty much everything within this tool, and it can show you anything from your disk usage to very specific memory settings. You can also add new widgets anywhere on your screen, in addition to the default ones, to configure exactly how you want this to look, and while it is confusing to configure first, it's also really powerful. However, if you ever get stuck or bored of configuring FPS Monitor, you can actually choose from a range of default preset scenes. There's some really minimal ones, and some with loads of stats. I personally quite like the 1440p one because it contains quite a lot of stats without being overpowering and getting in way too much. And it also looks fairly good at 4K resolutions too, in my opinion. The scene I'm using now doesn't show 1% lows, but that's my own choice. I could enable this if I wanted it to. It does show min and max FPS rates though, along with things like my fan speeds and more. Before wrapping up, the last FPS monitor that I wanted to cover is RivaTurner. This is actually what powers MSI Afterburner's FPS stats that I covered at the start of this video, but you can actually install this as a standalone application too, and it's also entirely free. You can then make some changes to the FPS counter that displays on screen, such as making the font size bigger or smaller, and also changing the, you know, the color of the font and things like that. One downside of this tool is that, as I touched on earlier, it tries to work out whether you're gaming or not, and then it only shows the FPS counter to you if you definitely are gaming. It does this by scanning for which game engines might be running on your computer. Unfortunately, this approach means that it won't always show up for every single game. It did work fine for me though, I should say, in Assassin's Creed Mirage, as you can see. I have a simple FPS counter appearing at the top left of my screen. It also appeared for me in an older Serious Sam game, so it's good to know that it can work reliably both with new and old games. I quite like the look of this FPS counter too, but naturally you can configure the exact location and size of this font if you want to. Before wrapping up, here's a quick tip. If you're using RivaTurner or MSI Afterburner and you're not seeing the FPS counter appear, make sure that Show Own Stats is enabled. I don't know exactly why you need to do this, but you just do. I wasn't actually seeing the FPS counter in any of my games before enabling this one setting, so make sure you check it. And that pretty much wraps up this video. Which FPS counter did you prefer the most? Please let me know down in the comments. I quite like AMD's one for simplicity, but then using the paid-for FPS monitor tool if I wanted some extra stats. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.